In this video, I want to show you guys now how to clean up and make your face look kind of flawless, get rid of any of those blemishes, and how to make you look amazing as well in Photoshop, even though I think everyone naturally also looks great. Without further ado, let's get to the video. Alright, so in my previous video, I showed you guys how to remove any background image to a headshot. So if you haven't seen that, make sure to check it out right here. But in this video, I'm going to show you guys now to take it a step further. So if you look closely at my skin, I got a couple of wrinkles here with the forehead, maybe a little bit of acne right here. It's not looking as high. I got all these freckles. Now, I'm not saying to not go all natural with your photos, but if you're like me and you just kind of want to dress it up a little bit to maybe not look a certain way and just look a little nicer, this is a easy hack to do it by using Photoshop. So go over here to the left right here, and there's a thing called the spot healing brush tool. So I'm going to click on this right here, and now I have this brush size, and I actually can increase this and decrease this by using the brackets, just like as if you were to increase and decrease the size of a brush. So with this patch tool, think of it as a tool that you can use to kind of mask out blemishes that are on your face with the outer colors that are surrounding that circle. So let's say I wanted to kind of get rid of this little bit right here. Here's what I can do. I can go over this little blemish right here, click it, and now it's going to be removed just like that. So I can do this as well with other parts of my image. So I can start doing up here. You can also click and drag if you want to cover more than just one section. Another thing to note with this though is that sometimes it's always not the most accurate or does the best job. So what I mean by that is, let's say you want to get rid of maybe some blemishes right here, but you click right here, it's going to make like this weird kind of smudge, because basically what it's doing is it's taking part of my eyebrow and trying to fill it in with the colors of my skin right above it. So you need to be careful when using this brush that you're kind of mindful of how you're using it. In these cases right here, it's pretty easy to get rid of these lines that you see right here, and you can just click as many times as you want. If you kind of shade in all of this, you do run the risk of like some weird stuff happening like this. I mean, this almost looks like I got like a scar on my head now. So sometimes doing a couple of dabs here and there is the best trick, and then you can just kind of go over place. See, again, that didn't do it as well. So what I would probably do is I would actually decrease the size and then maybe go in here. Maybe I want to get rid of these kind of bags underneath my eyes. I could do that. This day was probably a really rough day for taking pictures because I look really exhausted in this photo. So we're just gonna get rid of those right there and zoom in a little bit more. And to zoom in, all you have to do is Alt and then scroll with your mouse, especially if you have a Windows computer, and then you can just click here. If you're wanting to change the brush, you can also make it more hard, so it's gonna be more of like a really hard shape. I recommend just keeping a nice soft brush circle, so that way it's a little bit more fuzzy when it's doing the content aware. You can also choose different options here as well, but for this case, for just fixing up my face, I like to just mess around with the content aware. So I'm just gonna click a little bit more here, and then maybe this, and then watch this. I can actually remove freckles so quickly with Photoshop. So if I just click here, it's gone. Go there. Now, why would I want to get rid of freckles? I don't really know, but I just sometimes will do that with my photos just to kind of clean it up. Now again, go natural with your pictures if you want to stay all natural, but this is just a way in case you are trying to get that more just clean, kind of flawless look with your images. So obviously no one's born perfect, but this is a nice fun way to kind of clean up your own face if you do want to have that option. Another thing that I do in addition to doing the spot healing brush is I actually will take a brush like this, that's just a normal brush where you can actually paint colors on. It's almost as if I'm applying fake makeup to my face. So I'm gonna show you guys what I mean by that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit I on the keyboard, and that brings up the eyedropper tool. Then I'm gonna hit maybe right here, and that's gonna basically pick up that color of my skin. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit B on the keyboard, and now what I have the ability to do is I can actually start going in here, and I actually would recommend creating a new layer first just in case you mess up with this. But then you can actually go in here and see how that's super hard. So let's make the opacity like really light, and then also more of like a softer kind of brush. And now let's make it kind of big, and you just want to do this kind of lightly, not too much, but you'll see that it's kind of like smoothing out my skin a little bit in a nice way. Now if you go overboard with this, it's going to look a little strange, like that's kind of looking kind of weird. So maybe not do as much. So I like to just hit I to get an eyedropper tool in any section of the face and then go back to B on the keyboard to get to brush. Mess around with the brackets for the sizing of the brush and then just really smooth this out so it just looks kind of nice and flawless like this. Now you don't want to go too much with this again because it's going to look weird if you go too much, but you can always undo if you just do Control Z. You can always undo it if it's too much, but this is just a quick and easy way to really clean it up. And then maybe I want my nose to be fixed up a little bit with just smoothing it out. Do that. And I'm just kind of clicking around with the brush. And so as you can see here, this is a little too strong. So I actually would probably even go with a smaller opacity for this. And then maybe just blend this in a little bit more. And then right here, it's not looking the most attractive. So I kind of want to blend this in as well. So I'm just going to go right here and I'm just clicking a bunch to kind of blend this in, make it look real nice and smooth. Not as like greasy or unattractive looking. And this is something I will sometimes do for my actual thumbnail images for YouTube. So this is a great way to kind of clean up your headshot images for YouTube as well. So that's not looking too bad. Obviously, it's a little strong. So let me just decrease the opacity a little bit. And that's looking a little bit more natural. It looks really nice. You can also merge these two layers together by just clicking this layer and this one, right clicking, and then we can go to merge layers. And now those layers are just merged as one for this image. And you can mess around with the brightness and contrast again of this image if you want it to be brighter now. But now my skin looks a lot better than it did before. There's not all those wrinkles that you're seeing right here. The skin's looking smoother. Even my chin's looking a little bit more appealing to look at. So this is just a really quick way to clean up the face, all those acne and blemishes that maybe you're not a fan of having, or maybe you just didn't have a good day with a photo shoot. This is a quick way to do it. I could even keep going with this around the eye even if I wanted to. It just, the options are endless in how deep you really want to go into this and like how realistic or unrealistic you want to take this, but just know this is an easy option to just kind of really clean up your own headshot image. All right, so if you did like this video, make sure you give a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. It's free to do, so please do that. Also, if you are interested in learning things about PowerPoint, I actually have a course on Udemy for that, so I'll have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.